Hello and welcome to the last episode of diverCity for this year.
As the holidays approach, we have a lot of festive and fun news in store for you today.
With city's very own Christmas market,
winter wonderland at Hyde Park,
and Hanukkah.
But first, our very own Islamic society has been collecting presents and cards to give to the Great Ormond Street Hospital.
Today they packed the presents in one large gift box and sent it directly to them.
Our reporter, Catherine Iorio, went to find out more.
Throughout the week, the Islamic Society has been collecting money and presents for Great Ormond Street Hospital. For Hashil Al-Hatmi, head of Dawar, this event is more than just giving presents to children. It's about building a new play area for them as well.
This event is called Oh My Gosh. Oh My Gosh is referring to the Great Ormond Street Hospital. So basically, the Great Ormond Street Hospital, as you know, is one of the hospitals that take care of children from at newborn. They have certain physiological and mental impairments or deficiencies, so they take care of that. We're here to appreciate their work and to help fundraise for them by also not only donating for money, as you see, but we're also trying to donate and collect as much toys as we can so that we can present it to the children and also raise about a target of £500 so that we can build a new play area for them. When everything's done and over, after our Friday sermon, God willing, we're going to take everything with us, go straight to the hospital and present it to the children. We're hoping to have around two or three of our volunteers dressed as superheroes just to go and excite the children a little bit. It's all to get them a smile and to appreciate the work of what the hospital is doing and to also get the support of our city university, also as well as the student union, as they're very fascinated and amazed to see how much work and effort we put and how much we've raised upon it. So this is just something that we as Muslims, we feel that we need to contribute towards not only the community but as a society and the university and campus in itself.
diverCity, London.
With Christmas just around the corner, thousands of Londoners have been pouring into the city's spectacular winter wonderland.
We sent our intrepid reporter, Gian Maria Volpicelli, on a perilous yet cheerful journey to find Santa.
Hi, I'm Gian Volpicelli here in Winter Wonderland, Central London, Hyde Park, a family-oriented Christmas explosion of wonder. There's a lot of people coming from the doors, and I'm sure you're going to have a lot of fun. Is it true that you keep four little Santa helpers as slaves? We have tried, but no comment from the guy. Reindeers can be also very dangerous beasts. And now I'm going just for diverCity to challenge one of the most dangerous animals in Winter Wonderland. Yeah. Okay, Christmas is also about eating, and hot chocolate is definitely one of the staples of a very Christmassy diet. And here there are a lot of chocolate shops, and it's very tasty actually. Do you think you are going to gain weight during Christmas holidays?
Oh, most definitely, yes.
What are you going to eat?
Turkey, mulled wine, more beer, spirits.
So Christmas is unhealthy?
For me it is, yeah.
Okay.
Every weekend's unhealthy for me.
Thank you, bye. What did you ask to Santa Claus this year?
Nothing.
Why?
Because I'm happy.
Great.
I have enough.
Your soul is full of joy for Christmas.
Only healthiness and join the family.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay, we managed to find Santa's lair, but now the elephant in the room arrived. There's no Santa here. He's probably on strike or on holiday. Where are you, Santa? There are a lot of people who want to talk to you. I want to ask you some stock options, for example, or a Ukrainian model, and you are not here for me. I'm very disappointed, Santa. Gian Maria Volpicelli, diverCity News.
The Jewish Festival of Lights, Hanukkah, came to an end on Wednesday.
It was celebrating in Trafalgar Square, where the largest candelabrum in Europe was set to shine for 8 nights.
Our reporter, Gloria Schiavi, joined the cheerful gathering.
I'm in the heart of London, where the Jewish community is celebrating Hanukkah, the festivity of light. Boris Johnson opened the celebrations tonight, praising a very successful and generous Jewish community.
I want to see a boom in giving and a boom in the spirit of doing things for other people, which is what the Jewish community is all about in London.
Tonight, we are proud to be Jewish. We are proud to be citizens of this great capital city of London.
Count with me, please.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Happy Hanukkah, everyone!
Tonight is the second night, as you can see from the two little candles that are lit on the menorah, the candelabrum.
Many people say the second night is the best night, and I agree with that. Because all the family get together, you get fantastic events in London such as this. I mean, look at that menorah, it's fantastic.
He's a dreidel man. Jewish festival, we have a game that's included a dreidel, so we spin it, so we use him as a dreidel man to spin like that.
This is a happy evening, and people are celebrating singing and dancing in a pure Jewish spirit.
Happy Hanukkah!
A very, very happy Hanukkah, everybody.
Happy Hanukkah!
Happy Hanukkah.
Gloria Schiavi, Trafalgar Square, London.
City University will hold its first ever winter market in Northampton Square on December 12.
There'll be carolers and stalls set up to buy mulled wine and mince pies.
Let's take a look at what Vice President of Activities Rima Amin has planned for this event.
For the first time ever, City University's Northampton Square will be turned into a winter market.
So on December the 12th, we're going to be having lots of different stalls. So we've got local organisations coming in, some of which are doing arts, crafts. We've got a chocolatier. We're going to have a crepe van, and it's basically opening the square up so that staff, students, community, anyone can come along and be part of this event. And it's a very festive event. So we're going to also be having some of the societies doing Christmas carols in the bandstand, which will be really exciting.
From singing by City's Treble Clef Society and the Gospel Choir Society to Sadler's being turned into Santa's Grotto, the day will be turned into a magical social event.
We are turning Sadler's into a Santa's Grotto, essentially. So we're going to be decorating it, and it's going to be the place that students and staff and people can go to actually warm up. So we've made sure that they've got mulled wine, mince pies, hot chocolate. So we're going to have it as a kind of cozy, nice cozy event where people can go and warm up because it is quite cold as it's winter.
Wondering what the catch is? Well, let's just say there's no need for ball gowns and tuxedos this month.
So we had the option of doing the winter ball, which was done in previous years. But with that, we realised we can only sell a certain amount of tickets. So only a certain number of students will be able to partake in that. And since this is a celebration for the end of term, we wanted something where everyone can come along. So this is in substitute of the winter ball. It will be from 12 till 7. So students, you know, if they have lectures and they have an hour free, they can pop by. So it'll be happening from that time period, but it's open throughout.
I'm Catherine Iorio, London.
Supporters of West Papua's independent movement rallied outside the Indonesian embassy on Sunday.
They called to end Jakarta's 40-year control over this region.
Bernie de Busman has this report.
Supporters of West Papua's independence movement rallied outside Indonesia's embassy in London on Sunday to protest Indonesian rule of the region. West Papua, a former Dutch colony, declared independence on the 1st of December 1961, but was invaded and occupied by Indonesia 3 months later. Since then, Amnesty International estimates that at least 100,000 people have been killed by Indonesian security forces, and widespread allegations of human rights violations continue to this day.
It's a killing, torture, intimidate my people. So that's why we're here to show them we never give up, we will fight until we be free from colonialism, slavery, and we want to have own country and we want to run our own country.
Dominic Brown, a documentary filmmaker who's traveled to West Papua, described conditions in the region.
Basically, there's no freedoms at all in West Papua, so if you raise the West Papua flag, you get put in prison for 15 years. there's no freedom of political speech, so that, you know, it's only kind of Indonesian political parties. There can't be any Papuan parties. It's basically, you know, Indonesia is there just to set the resources, and the people, they don't have any jobs.
The Indonesian embassy declined to comment on the protest, which took place simultaneously with ones in Papua New Guinea, Australia, and across Europe. Reporting from London, I'm Brent de Busman.
Holiday shopping has officially begun.
Our leading ladies were put to the test in a diverCity special, the Queens of Shopping.
Each girl had 20 minutes to find the perfect New Year's Eve outfit and then was judged on whose was best.
Let's take a look.
Tis the season, and you know what that means. Shopping! With Christmas sales expecting to be a staggering £72.2 billion, or £351 per person, according to the Center for Retail Research, more people will be out shopping this season. We took our leading ladies, Jade, Sarah, Faye, and Eugenie, out shopping for a little diverCity special, the Queens of Shopping. Each leading lady had 20 minutes to find the perfect New Year's Eve outfit.
I don't think this is enough, but we're trying to figure it out. Still, the most important thing is the accessories.
Lots of glitter. Glitter, glitter.
Okay, so I've gone with the jumpsuit. That is definitely what I want to do, but I just need the accessories to go with it.
That could be it. That could be the dress. But probably that one too. I can work on the accessories and I'll show the shoes. Jingle
around the clock. I'm wearing this little black dress, because that's a classic thing to do, and then this colorful, sparkly thing over it, and ideally I would probably have like a longer necklace with it, or maybe some really long earrings, because it's all about accessories, but we can't show that right now.
So this is my outfit. I think it's just perfect. There's this in the back, so you can swing it back.
Yeah.
It's not obscene. And it's shiny. So you want everybody to look at you for your reason. I think that's just perfect. Giddy up, jingle
horse, pick up your feet. Jingle. I'm wearing a crop top with a skirt, high-waisted, and a cute fur coat. Strappy high heels with long earrings and some amazing makeup, and yeah, that would be, and lots of arm things, bracelets, gold bracelets especially. Yep. Snowing and blowing
up bushels of fun. Okay, so I went with a jumpsuit because New Year's Eve is a cold evening, so I thought something that covers you up but is still stylish at the same time would be a really good option. So obviously with a little bit of heel going on, a belt to position in, actually the right size is always a good thing to go for because it's huge on me. And then a statement necklace, which I wasn't allowed to bring in either, but this one works, for example, because turquoise clashes nicely with the pink. So that's what I've gone for New Year's Eve.
It was really difficult to choose between elegant England, fancy France, extravagant India, and awesome USA. But I've done some thinking, and the real winner is...
Thank you for watching the last episode of diverCity for this year. We'll be back in January.
Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter.
Happy holidays!
Kala Christoyenna.
Nei salki shubkam nei.
Shislivo Rozhdestva.
S lyubovyu iz Rossii.
Feliz Navidad.
Krachum ferichit.
Fröhliche Weihnachten.
Eid Milad Said.
Buon Natale.
Sretan Božić.
Joyeux Noël.
From the city.